Jeg takker dig, Jesus.
I thank you, Jesus.
For du døde for mig.
Because you died for me.
Halleluja. Vi elsker dig, Jesus.
We love you, Jesus.
Vi elsker dig, Jesus.
We love you, Jesus.
Oh, vi elsker dig, Jesus. Oh, vi elsker dig, Jesus. Vi elsker dig. Åbn din mund og proklamer, jeg elsker dig, Jesus. Jeg elsker dig, Jesus. Halleluja. Oh, halleluja. Jeg elsker dig, Jesus. Halleluja. Halleluja. Der er ingen ligesom dig.
There is none like you.
Der er ingen, der kommer op på siden af dig.
There's no one by your side.
Du er altid den samme.
You're always the same.
Der er ingen skygge af forandring, der kommer og går.
There's no shadow of change that
du
comes
er
and
den
goes.
Samme.
You are the same.
Jesus Kristus.
Jesus Christ.
Er den samme.
Is the same.
I går.
Yesterday.
Og i dag.
And today.
Og han er den samme for evigt.
And he'll be the same forever.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay. Kan vi give Herren en ordentlig klap salve?
Amen.
Halleluja. Gud er god.
God is good.
Må gerne tage plads.
Please be seated.
I dag, inden vi skal ære møderne,
today before we honor the mothers,
så vil jeg gerne, jeg vil gerne bare tale om nogle ord, to ord faktisk.
I just want to talk about two words.
Som jeg oplevede, at Herren de sidste par uger, da han sagde det til mig igen og igen og igen.
I just felt that these words God has told me again and again and
again. Og sidste søndag, der blev det endnu stærkere.
And last Sunday it was even stronger.
Og i fredags, der var jeg i Jules Minde og prædike.
Last Friday I was in Jules Minde to preach.
Det var faktisk første gang jeg var uden for huset her og prædike siden februar sidste år.
And that's actually the first time I've been out of the house to preach since February last year.
Det er et mirakel.
That's a miracle.
Men vi var i hvert fald dernede.
But we were down there.
Og der blev du endnu stærkere for mig.
And there it got even stronger for me.
Selvom vi kørte et dårdyr ned på vej hjem.
Even though we ran down a deer on our way home.
Men Gud, han er god.
But God is good.
Men de to ord, som jeg fik,
but the two words that I got,
som jeg gerne vil snakke om den her morgen,
that I want to talk about this morning,
de er de her to ord.
It is these two words.
Men Herren.
But Lord.
Men Herren.
But Lord.
Men Herren.
But Lord.
Ikke jamen her. Ikke jamen her.
Not yes, but.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Og nu skal du godt få en anelse om, hvor vi bevæger os hen.
And I'll get you a hint of where we're going.
Sidste søndag, der snakker vi også lidt om Salme 37.
Last Sunday, we also talked about Psalm 37.
Og jeg vil gerne dele lidt med dig om Davids liv i dag.
I want to share a little bit about the life of David today.
I fredags, der talte jeg om Josefs liv.
Last Friday, I talked about the life of Joseph.
I den her søndag, vil jeg også snakke bare lidt om Davids liv.
This one, I want to talk about the life of David.
Han siger her.
He says here.
Jeg har været ung.
I have been young.
Og nu er jeg gammel.
And now I'm old.
Men jeg har aldrig.
But I have never.
Jeg kan godt lide det der. Men.
But.
Det kan godt være, at dine omstændigheder, de siger det eller det.
Maybe your circumstance says this or this.
Men.
But.
Giv det luk døren dernede bagved.
Please close the door in the back.
Men.
But.
Og det er det, jeg gerne vil snakke om den her morgen.
That's what I want to talk about this
det
morning.
Det kan godt være, du er ung.
Maybe you're young.
Og det kan godt være, du er gammel nu.
And maybe you're old.
Men.
But.
David, han siger, jeg har aldrig.
But David says, I have never.
Set en retfærdig.
Seen a righteous.
Som er forladt.
That is abandoned.
Eller har tækket sit brød.
Or have been begging for his bread.
Men den retfærdige, han ynkes altid ud og låner.
But the righteous always humble himself.
Og hans afkom er til velsignelse.
And his descendant is a blessing.
Amen.
Amen.
Men.
But.
Ung har jeg været.
I've been young.
Gammel er jeg nu.
I'm old now.
Men. Jeg har but, aldrig.
But I have never.
Og det er det, jeg godt vil snakke lidt om i den her morgen.
That's what I want to talk about
jeg
this morning.
Jeg har aldrig, siger David.
I have never, says David.
Set en, der stoler på Herren.
Seen one that trusted in the Lord.
Vær forladt.
Be abandoned.
Eller tækket sit brød.
or beckon for his
jeg
breath.
Jeg har levet et helt liv, siger han.
I've lived the whole life, he
men
says.
Men jeg har aldrig.
But I've never.
Det er et stærkt vidnesbyrd.
That's a strong testimony.
I Salme 20, vers 8-9, der står der.
In Psalm 20, verse 8-9, it says.
Hans Jørgen, han spørger nogle gange mig, når vi er heroppe i dagligdagen.
And John sometimes asks me when we're here in the daily day.
Hvor mange hestekræfter har din bil?
How many horsepower do your car has?
Det ved jeg ingenting om.
I don't know.
Det eneste jeg ved om min bil, det er den sort.
The only thing I know about my car is that it's black.
Jeg har ingen interesse i det overhovedet.
I have no interest in it.
Jeg vil bare have, at den skal starte, og så kører mig derhen, hvor jeg skal, og så hjem igen.
It just needs to start, drive me to where I need to go, and
men,
bring me back
men
home.
Men Hans Jørgen, han vil gerne vide, hvor mange hestekræfter har din bil.
But Hans Jørgen wants to know how many horsepower does your car
men
has.
Men jeg har ingen idé om, hvor mange hestekræfter en bil har.
But I have no idea how much it has.
Men jeg ved, en hest er en stærk ting.
But I know that a horse is a strong thing.
Så vi måler kraften på en bil i hestekræfter.
So we measure the power of a car in the power of a horse.
Og David, han siger her i Salme 20, vers 8 og 9.
And David says here in Psalm 20, verse 8 to 9.
Der er nogen, der stoler på heste, og andre stoler på vognene.
Some trust the horses, other trust the carriages.
Men!
But!
Halleluja!
Halleluja!
Der er nogen, der stoler på heste og vogne, men!
Some trust the horses and
vi vinder sejr.
But we win
ved
the victory.
Ved Herren vores Guds navn.
By the name of our Lord.
Ved du hvad du kan?
Do you know what you can?
Du kan sætte din tillid til de forkerte ting.
You can put your trust in the wrong things.
Du kan sætte din tillid til de forkerte ting i dit liv.
You can put your trust in the wrong things in your life.
Men
but
hvis du vil sætte din tillid til Herren,
if you'll put your trust in the Lord,
så kan du sejre ved Hans navn.
You can gain victory by his name.
For mig, jeg er bange for heste.
I'm scared of horses.
De virker voldsomt store.
They seem terribly big.
Men de er fuld af kraft.
But they're full of power.
Der er mange ting i vores liv.
There are many things in our lives.
Der er fuld af kraft.
There's full of power.
Men hvis du vil stole på Herren,
but if you'll trust the Lord,
så vil du altid vinde sejr.
You'll always win.
Davids søn.
The son of David.
Salomon.
Salomon.
Han siger i Ordsprogene 10, vers 22.
He says in Proverbs 10, 22.
Herren,
the Lord,
velsignelse, den gør rig.
The blessing of the Lord makes you rich.
Slid og slæb lægger ingenting til.
Toil and work doesn't add any more.
Det er Herrens velsignelse.
It's the blessing of the Lord.
Ikke hestenes kraft.
Not the power of the horses.
Eller vognernes kraft.
Or the power of the carriages.
Men det er Herrens velsignelse.
But the blessing of the Lord.
Men det er Herrens kraft.
But it's his power.
Det gør, at du kan vinde sejr.
That makes sure that you can win the victory.
David, han siger også i Salme 34, vers 20.
David also says in Psalm 34, verse 20.
Den retfærdiges lidelser er mange.
The sufferings of the righteous is many.
Vi hører nogle gange, det er bare tro på Jesus, så går alle dine problemer væk.
Many times we hear, just trust in Jesus and all your problems will go away.
Det er ikke rigtigt.
That is not true.
Du har også problemer som en kristen.
You also have problems as a Christian.
Men!
But!
Herren, han frier dig af dem alle sammen.
The Lord will liberate you from all of them.
Amen!
Amen.
Bare fordi du har sagt ja til Jesus.
Just because you said yes to Jesus.
Har det ikke gjort dig immun over for problemer og svære ting?
It haven't made you immune over to difficult things.
Men det at du har sagt ja til Jesus.
But that you have said yes to Jesus.
Der har du inviteret en stærkere kraft ind i dit liv.
You have invited a stronger force into your life.
Og det er Herren.
And that is the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Den retfærdiges kampe er mange.
The fights of the righteous is many.
Problemerne for den retfærdige er lige så mange som den uretfærdige.
The problems of the righteous is just as many as the unrighteous.
Udfordringerne for den kristne er lige så mange som den ikke kristne.
The challenges for the Christian is just as many as for the unchristian.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Se, der er forskellen.
That is the difference.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Udfrier dem af dem alle sammen.
Liberates them from all of them.
Amen.
Amen.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Og jeg har bestemt på det hele de sidste 2 uger, så jeg tænkt på det her. Men Herren.
And I've just thought about this for the last 2 weeks. But the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
I Salme 103, tror jeg, der står.
In Psalm 103, I think it is.
Der står der.
It says,
min sjæl lov Herren.
My soul praise the Lord.
Og glem ikke alle Herrens velgerninger.
And do not forget all of the Lord's deeds.
Hvordan opmunter du dig selv i Herren?
How do you encourage yourself in him?
Det gør du som David, han gjorde i Salme 103.
You do it like David did in Psalm 103.
Han siger, min sjæl lov Herren.
He says, my soul praise the Lord.
Og alt inden i mig.
And everything in me.
Det skal love hans hellige navn.
Will praise his wonderful name.
Når det går ned.
When it goes down.
Når det går op.
When it goes up.
Når du har penge.
When you have money.
Når du ingen penge har.
And when you have no money.
Når ingenting lykkes.
When nothing succeeds.
Når alt det lykkes.
When everything succeeds.
Min sjæl lov Herren.
My soul praise the Lord.
Og glem ikke alle hans velgerninger.
And do not forget all of his good deeds.
Amen.
Amen.
Jeg er syg.
I am sick.
Men Herren,
but the Lord,
er min helbreder.
Is my healer.
Jeg har ingenting i min lomme.
I have nothing in my.
Men Herren, han er min forsørger.
But the Lord is my provider.
Det var så et godt sted at sige amen.
It's a good place to say amen.
Halleluja. Davids liv i Bibelen.
The life of David in the Bible.
Er ikke kun omtalt, eller David er ikke kun omtalt i Bibelen som en superhelt.
David is not just talked about in the Bible as a superhero.
Men hvis du læser Davids historie,
but if you're reading the stories about David,
så vil du se, at der er en lang liste over Davids svagheder.
You'll see that there is a long list over his weaknesses.
Over hans synder.
Over his sins.
At de bliver ramset op.
That they are cleansed.
Udstillet for hele verden for evigt.
Poured out for all the world to see forever.
Men Herren,
but the Lord,
han var nådig.
He was merciful.
Og barmhjertig.
And had mercy on him.
Davids historie.
The story of David.
Og Davids liv.
And the life of David.
Det er et kald til dig.
It's a call for you.
Det er et kald til os.
A calling for us.
Og det er et kald til alle troende.
It's a calling for all believers.
Om hvordan vi kan bygge vores liv.
About how we can build our lives.
I svære tider.
In difficult times.
I svære omstændigheder.
And in difficult circumstances.
Vi får at vide i Apostlenes Gerninger 13.
We get to see in Acts 13.
Og i 1. Samuels bog.
The first book of Samuel.
Kapitel 13 også.
Also chapter 13.
Der får vi at vide, at David.
We see that David.
Han får det her mærkat sat på sig.
He get this sticker put on him.
At han er en mand efter Guds hjerte.
That he is a man after the heart of God.
Far, han har gjort noget.
Before he has done anything.
Han er bare en dreng hjemme ved hans far.
He's just a child in the house of his father.
Han er en hyrde for sin fars får.
He's a shepherd for the sheep of his
Samuel,
father.
Samuel, han kommer for at skal salve ham med olie.
Samuel comes to anoint him with oil.
Og han får det vidnesbyrd fra Gud.
And he receives this testimony from
at
God.
At han er en mand efter Guds eget hjerte.
That he is a man after the heart of God.
Far, han har gjort nogen ting.
Before he has done anything.
Før han var konge.
Before he became a
Før
king.
Før han var en militær sejr.
Before he won victories.
Før han opbyggede lovsangstjenesten i Israel.
And before he built up the worship in Israel.
Der var han en mand efter Guds hjerte.
He was a man after the heart of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Han blev fristet i ørkenen i 40 dage.
He got tempted in the desert for 40 days.
Han blev ledt af Helligånden ud i ørkenen.
He got led by the Holy Spirit to the desert.
Han kom ud af ørkenen fyldt af den Hellige Ånd.
And he came out of the desert filled with the Holy Spirit.
Han var salvet.
He was anointed.
Til at træde ind i sin tjeneste.
To step into his ministry.
Han blev salvet før han havde gjort nogen ting.
He got anointed before he did anything.
Han blev iført Herrens kraft før han havde gjort nogen mirakler.
He got the power of God before he made miracles.
Vi tænker tit på den her måde.
Many times we believe like this.
At man skal gøre noget for at få.
That we need to do to receive.
Men Herren, han ønsker at vise dig ren noget.
But the Lord desires to show you pure mercy.
Amen. Og Amen. Så begynder vi at vandre i den noget.
And then we start walking in that grace.
Amen. Jeg er.
I am.
Og derfor gør jeg.
That's why I do.
Religion siger, jeg gør for at blive eller få.
Religion says that I do to get or to receive.
Men kristendom siger, jeg gør, fordi jeg er.
But Christianity says, I do because I am.
Amen.
Amen.
David var en mand efter Guds hjerte.
David was a man after the heart of God.
Han var en tilbeder.
He was a worshipper.
Når han var alene.
If he was alone.
Og han var en tilbeder.
And he was a worshipper.
Når han var sammen med andre.
When he was with others.
Hans liv, det var et liv i tilbedelse.
His life was a life in worship.
Han slog en løve ihjel.
He killed the lion.
Han slog en bjørn ihjel.
And a bear.
Og stolede udelukkende på Herren.
And only trusted in the Lord.
Hans tillid til Gud.
His confidence in
blev
God.
Ikke forandret af omstændighederne.
Didn't got changed because of circumstances.
Mens jeg stod og tilbad Herren her.
While we are worshiping the Lord here.
Så kom jeg til at tænke på det Herrens år 2009.
I started thinking in the... Starts to think about the name of the Lord 2009.
Det var lige efter finanskrisen.
Just after the financial crisis.
Vi har en kæmpe krise i vores kirke.
We have a giant crisis here in our church.
Som var økonomi.
That was our economy.
Vi havde ingen penge.
We had no money.
Skolen gav underskud.
The school was in deficit.
Joshua børnehaven gav underskud.
The kindergarten was in deficit.
Kirken gav en kæmpe underskud.
The church also a giant
deficit. Når jeg lå hjemme i min seng om aftenen, så lagde jeg hovedet budet over, bare for at slippe for at høre. Jeg troede, jeg kunne få stemmerne til at gå væk.
When I was at home, I was just lying home with my pillow over my head to try to calm the voices.
Det var som om 1,000 kilo, de pressede sig ind i hovedet på mig i hvert fald.
Like 1,000 kilos just pressed into my head.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Han udfrier dem af dem alle sammen.
He liberated us from all
vi
of it.
Vi står stadigvæk her 12 år senere.
We are still standing here 12 years later.
Vi står stadig stærkere end vi gjorde i 2009.
We are still stronger than we were in 2009.
For Herren.
Because the Lord.
Han greb ind.
He intervened.
For Herren.
Because the Lord.
Han var trofast.
He was faithful.
Amen.
Amen.
Gud er god.
God is good.
Han er altid god.
He's always good.
Den retfærdiges lidelser og kampe kan være mange.
The sufferings of the righteous and the battles can be many.
Men Herren,
but the Lord,
han udfrier.
He liberates.
Herren, han er i færd med at forberede dig til velsignelse.
The Lord is preparing you for blessings.
Herren, han er i færd med at sætte dig op for en velsignelse.
And he is preparing you to sit for blessings.
Da Josef han blev kaldet.
When Joseph was called,
da var han 17 år gammel.
He was 17 years old.
Da han blev statsminister i Egypten.
When he became a minister in Egypt,
da er han 30 år gammel.
He was 30 years old.
13 år.
13 years.
Til hans syn og drøm går i opfyldelse, at hans far og brødre, de bøjer sig for ham.
13 years from his vision became a reality.
Da er han 40 år.
He was 40.
23 år.
23 years.
Forbered Herren ham.
The Lord prepared him.
Da forbered Herren ham.
He prepared him.
Ned fra en brønd.
From the end of the well.
Han forberedte ham som en slave.
He prepared him as a slave.
Han forberedte ham i Potifars hus.
He prepared him in the
han
house of Potiphar.
Han forberedte ham mens han var i fængsel.
And he prepared him while he was in jail.
Han forberedte ham mens han blev løjet om af en kvinde.
And he prepared him while he was lied about by a woman.
Hvorfor?
Why?
Alle de ting forberedte ham til at blive premierminister.
All of these things prepared him to be a prime minister.
Det du går igennem.
What you're passing through.
Det forbereder dig.
Is preparing you.
Til det Herren han er i færd med at gøre dig parat til.
To what the Lord is preparing you to do.
Giv ikke op.
Don't give up.
For Herren.
Because the Lord.
For Herren.
Because the Lord.
Han er i færd med at velsigne dig.
He is about to
amen.
Bless you.
Amen. Gud han er god.
God is good.
Det tog mellem 10 og 13 år.
It took between 10 and 13 years.
For den dags Samuel, han salvede ham som konge.
From the day that Samuel anointed David as a king.
10 til 13 år.
10 to 13 years.
Gik der fra den dag.
That went from this day.
Og indtil han fik den første krone på sit hoved.
And until he received the first crown.
David han blev prøvet i årevis.
David was tried for years.
For at han kunne være forberedt for herligheden.
For him to be prepared for glory.
Og ansvar.
And responsibility.
Som der fulgte med.
That was coming along with it.
Guds ord.
The word of God
viser os Davids liv, det er fyldt med prøvelser.
Shows us that the trials of David was many.
Hans karakter blev prøvet.
His character was tried.
På samme måde kan du forvente at blive prøvet.
In the same way you can expect to be tried.
Det rene guld,
the pure gold,
det kommer igennem ild.
Comes through fire.
De dyrebareste ædelsten,
the most precious stones,
de bliver skabt af et stærkt tryk.
They're created by a powerful pressure.
Hvis du vil have det rene guld i dit liv,
if you want the pure gold in your life,
så skruer Herren lidt op for varmen.
Then the Lord is going to turn up the heat.
Hvis du vil have den dyrebare ædelsten i dit liv,
if you want the precious stones in your life,
så vær parat til at det presser lidt fra alle sider.
Be sure that it's going to pressure from all
det
sides.
Det betyder ikke,
it doesn't mean,
at Herren han har forladt dig.
That he has left you.
Det betyder, at Herren han er med dig.
That means that he's
so
with
du
you.
Kan sige,
so that you can say,
jeg blev presset fra alle sider.
I was pressured from all sides.
Jeg gik igennem ild og vand.
I went through fire and water.
Men Herren,
but the Lord,
han stod mig bi.
He was with me.
Amen.
Amen.
Det er vores vidnesbyrd.
That's our testimony.
Jeg føler, som om hele mit liv det brænder.
I feel like all of my life is burning.
Men Herren,
but the Lord,
han leder dig til sejr.
He will lead you to victory.
Altid.
Always.
Det profetiske ord, det er mange, der ikke forstår det her.
Prophetic word, and many don't understand this.
Hvis du har et profetisk ord over dit liv,
if you have a prophetic word over your life,
så går det ikke automatisk i opfyldelse.
It won't happen automatically.
Det gør det ikke.
It won't.
Paulus siger til Timotheus.
Paul says to Timothy.
Du skal tage det profetiske ord, som jeg gav til dig.
You need to take the prophetic word that I gave to you.
Og du skal stride ved hjælp af det ord.
And you need to strive with that word.
Tror det er 1. Timotheus 2:18.
I think it's 1 Timothy 2:18.
Det ord, som Herren har talt til dig.
That word that the Lord has told you.
Det holder du frem.
You will keep that forward.
Og du siger, men Herre,
you say, but Lord,
du har sagt,
you have said,
Josef, da han sad nede i brønden,
Joseph, when he was in the well,
inden hans brødre solgte ham,
before his brother sold him,
så er jeg sikker på, at Josef, han sagde, men Herre,
I'm sure he said, but Lord,
du viste mig jo,
you showed me.
Og så kom han op,
and then he came up,
og blev solgt som slave,
and got sold as a slave.
Han står nøgen nede på et slavemarked,
he's standing naked on a slave market,
i Egypten,
in Egypt.
Og jeg er sikker på indeni, så han råbt.
And I'm sure on the inside he's been shouting.
Men Herre,
but Lord,
du har jo sagt.
You have said.
Det er sådan du strider ved det profetiske ord.
That's how you strive with.
Du holder fast i løftet.
You hold on to the promise.
Nu sidder jeg nede i brønden.
I'm sitting in the well.
Men Herre,
but Lord,
du har en anden plads for mig.
You have another place for me.
Nu er jeg solgt som slave til Egypten.
I've been sold as a slave to Egypt.
Men Herre,
but Lord,
du har en anden plads for mig.
You have another place for me.
Nu sidder jeg sandelig i fængsel.
I'm sitting in prison.
Men Herre,
but Lord,
du har en anden plads for mig.
You have another room for me.
Det er sådan en retfærdig beder.
That's how the righteous prays.
Det er sådan den retfærdige, sådan en som du og jeg holder fast i det Gud har sagt.
That's how someone like you and me hold on to what God has said.
For at se det profetiske ord over dit liv, det blev opfyldt.
To see the word of God, the prophetic word.
Så kræver det, at du deltager.
It requires that you participate.
Hvis du bare ligger hjemme i sofaen og spiser chips og drikker cola.
If you're just eating chips and drinking cola on your couch,
så går dit profetiske ord aldrig opfyldes.
Then the prophetic word will never be.
Hvis du vil se det profetiske ord gå i opfyldelse,
if you will see the prophetic word come to be,
så fortsætter du med at gå, når det gør ondt.
Then you continue walking while it hurts.
Så fortsætter du med at gå, når du ikke kan forstå nogen som helst ting.
You continue walking even though you don't understand anything.
I 2013.
In 2013.
Der havde jeg for at sige, havde et helvedes år.
I had a hellish year.
Det var mit helvedes år.
That was my year of hell.
Hvis der findes sådan nogen.
If that exists.
Jeg råbte til Gud.
I was shouting to God.
Jeg sagde til Herren.
I told him.
Hvor er du henne?
Where are you?
Hvad sker der?
What's happening?
Og da jeg ingen svar fik fra ham, for han svarer aldrig på hvorfor.
And when I never got an answer because he never replies why.
Det var en lektie jeg har lært.
That is something I learned.
Gud han har aldrig svaret når jeg har spurgt hvorfor.
God has never answered when I've asked
ikke
why.
Ikke en eneste gang.
Not even once.
Men når jeg har sagt hvad nu?
But when I said what now?
Så kommer svar og ord.
Then the answer and the word comes.
Hvorfor?
Why?
Kan du ingenting bruge til?
You can't use that for
anything. Det er som om at døren den er fuldstændig lukket.
It's like the door just completely shut.
Og der er ikke en lyd, kun stillhed.
There is no sound, just quietness.
Han har ikke behov for at forklare mig eller dig alting.
You don't need to explain everything to you and me.
De skjulte ting er for Herren.
The hidden things are for
the
Lord. De
åbenbare, det er for sådan nogen som os.
The revelation is for some
så hvorfor?
Like so why?
At der er en dårlig bøn.
Is a bad prayer.
Men når du begynder at sige, Herre, hvad nu?
So when you start saying, Lord, what now?
Hvad vil du nu?
What do you want to do now?
Hvilken retning nu?
Which direction now?
Hvorhen nu?
Where are we going now?
Hvad skal der ske nu?
What is now going to happen?
Så begynder han at tale.
Then he starts speaking.
Så det her, den der annus horrible 2013.
So the bad year of 2013.
Når Gud ingenting siger.
When God doesn't speak.
Så begynder du at give mennesker skylden.
Then you start blaming people.
Og det gjorde jeg også.
And I also did that.
Jeg begynder at beklage mig til Herren.
I started bickering to the Lord.
Og sige til ham, Gud.
And say, God.
Hvorfor er der ingen af dem, der siger, de elsker mig?
Why is there no one that's telling me that they love me?
Og holder af mig.
And they care about
dem,
me.
Dem, der stadigvæk er tilbage.
The ones that are still left.
Hvorfor er der ingen, der Why? Kan se, hvor dårlig jeg har det?
Why is there no one that can see how bad I feel?
Det var sådan, jeg havde det.
That's how I felt.
Hvorfor?
Why?
Er der ingen af dem, jeg kender?
Is there none of who I know?
Af dem, jeg har ledt i mange år?
The one that I've guided for many years.
Hvorfor er der ingen?
Why is there none?
Der kan se min situation.
That can see my situation.
Jeg glemmer aldrig.
I never forget.
Det som Herren han svarede mig tilbage.
What he told me.
For jeg fandt ud af.
Because I found out.
At det var ikke nogen af de andres skyld.
That it wasn't the fault of the others.
Ved I hvad han sagde til mig?
You know what he told me?
Han sagde sådan her.
He said like this.
Han sagde.
He said.
Der er ingen der har set det.
There's none that has seen it.
For jeg.
Because I.
Og det var Herren der talte.
That was the Lord who said
it. Han sagde jeg.
Because I.
Har blindet deres øjne.
Have blinded their eyes.
Hold op. Jeg har blindet deres øjne.
I have blinded their eyes.
Fordi jeg vil tale med dig.
Because I want to speak to you.
Og Herren han vil tale med dig.
And the Lord wants to speak to you.
Så nogen gang.
So sometimes.
Er det ikke de andres skyld.
It's not the other's fault.
Det er Herren.
It's the Lord.
Der forbereder en samtale med dig.
That prepares a conversation with you.
Amen.
Amen.
Det profetiske ord over dit liv.
The prophetic word over your life.
Det kræver at du deltager.
Requires that you participate.
Selv når det er mørkt.
Even when it's dark.
Du kan have dage hvor det er så mørkt at du tænker jeg bliver bare liggende i sengen.
You can have days where it's so dark that you just feel like laying in bed.
Jeg har haft dage, hvor jeg har bare sagt, nej, jeg kommer ikke afsted nu.
I've had days where I'm just thinking, no, I'm not going to be leaving now.
Det er bare mørkt.
It's just dark.
Nogle gange.
Sometimes.
Har der været nogen, der har sagt, kom så op.
There's been someone saying, come on, get up.
Som jeg ved, de har bedt for mig.
As I know, they have prayed for me.
Fordi Gud, han giver dig også forbedere.
Because God also gives you people to pray for you.
Så lad være med at give op.
So don't give up.
Winston Churchill, han sagde.
Winston Churchill said.
Når du går igennem helvede på jorden.
When you're going through hell on earth.
Fortsæt med at gå.
Continue walking.
Lad være med at lægge dig ned.
Don't lie down.
Fortsæt med at gå.
Continue walking.
Hold dig tæt til mænd og kvinder.
Hold yourself close to men and
som
women.
Som selv går videre.
That they themselves are moving on.
Og du kommer igen.
And you'll pass through.
For Herren.
Because the Lord.
For Herren.
Because the Lord.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Han er stor nok.
He's great enough.
Han er rig nok.
He's rich enough.
Og han er stærk nok.
And he's strong enough.
Til at føre dig igen.
To follow you through.
Deltag.
Participate.
Deltag.
Participate.
Amen.
Amen.
Gud er god.
God is good.
Lige nogle få minutter mere.
Just a few more minutes.
Josef og David. Og jeg kan nå det hele alligevel.
Josef and David.
Jeg opgiver. Jeg tager det sidste. Josef og David.
Joseph and David.
Studer deres liv, når du kommer hjem.
Study their lives when you go home.
Gud han sætter dig op til velsignelse.
God are putting you up for
Gud
blessings.
Han sætter dig aldrig op til fiasko.
He's never gonna put you up for failure.
Gud han forbereder dig til vækst.
God prepares you for growth.
Davids prøvelser i hans liv.
The trials of David in his life.
Det tvang ham.
Forced him.
Til at fokusere.
To focus.
Prøvelserne i dit liv.
On the trials in your life.
Kampene i dit liv.
The fights in your life.
Svinger dig.
Forces you.
Til at fokusere.
Focus.
På din identitet.
On your identity.
Og på dit formål.
And on your purpose.
Djævlen vil distrahere dig.
The devil will try to distract you.
Men alle de her ting.
But all of these things.
De er der for at du skal fokusere.
Are here for you to focus.
På din identitet.
On your identity.
Og på dit formål.
And on your purpose.
Okay, Josef.
Okay, Joseph.
Tror du stadigvæk at din mor og far og brødre, de skal komme og bøje sig for dig?
Do you still think that your brothers, mother and father are gonna bend down for you?
Nu når du er slave i et andet land.
Now when you're a slave in another country.
Tror du det?
Do you still believe that?
Kender du stemmen ind i dit hoved?
Do you know that voice in your head?
Tror du virkelig på det?
Do you really believe that?
Prøv at se din situation.
Look at your situation.
Og det er der Josef han sagde, men Herren.
That's when Joseph said, but
udfrier mig af dem alle.
Will liberate me from all of it.
David.
David.
Tror du stadigvæk at du skal blive konge?
Do you still believe that you're going to be a king?
Når alle de forkaster dig.
When all are rejecting
din
you.
Din mor og far har forkastet dig.
Your mother and father rejected
din
you.
Din brødre har forkastet
your
dig.
Your brothers have rejected you.
Din familie har forkastet dig.
Your family has rejected
din
you.
Din leder Saul har forkastet
your
dig.
Your leader Saul has rejected you.
Din egen kone forkaster dig.
Your own wife rejects you.
Din landsmænd forkaster dig.
The ones from your own country reject you.
Filisterne, som er dine fjender, du har hjulpet, de forkaster dig.
Philistines that you helped, they have rejected you.
Din egen mægtige mænd, er det ikke dem, der vil stene dig nu?
Your own mighty men, is that not the ones that want to stone you now?
Hvad gjorde David?
What did David do?
Han fokuserede på sit identitet.
He focused on his own
han
identity.
Han fokuserede på sit formål.
On the purpose of his
og
life.
Og i hver situation.
And in every situation.
Er jeg sikker på, han sagde.
I'm sure he said.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Han frier mig af dem alle sammen.
He's gonna liberate me from all of it.
Du kender jeg ikke alle situationer her.
I don't know the situation of everybody in here.
Men jeg har et ord til dig.
But I have a word for you.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Han vil udfri dig.
You'll liberate
Adam you alle sammen.
Of all of it.
Jeg kender ikke den kamp du står i lige nu.
I don't know the fight that you're in right now.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Er det navn du kan vinde sejr ved.
Is the name that you can win victory by.
Jeg ved ikke hvilken økonomisk situation du står i lige nu.
I don't know your situation economically.
Men Herren.
But the Lord.
Han er din forsørger.
He's your provider.
Far, vi takker dig.
Father, we thank you.
At du er vores Gud.
That you are our God.
At du er vores Herre.
That you are our Lord.
Du har al magt i himlen og på jorden.
You have all power in heaven and earth.
Der er ingen, der kommer på siden af dig.
No one is by your side.
Og vi sætter vores lid til dig.
And we put our trust in you.
Amen.
Amen.
Du har sagt.
You have said.
At visdoms begyndelse.
That the beginning of wisdom.
Det er frygte Herren.
It is fearing the Lord.
Visdoms begyndelse.
Beginning of wisdom.
Det er at gøre Adonai til herre i vores liv.
To make Adonai Lord in our life.
Vi gør dig til herre i vores liv.
And we make you Lord in our lives.
Og vi ved du har magt.
And we know that you have power.
Til rigt mål.
To a rich
i enhver omstændighed.
In every circumstance.
Og give os alt.
To give us everything.
Hvad vi trænger til.
That we need.
For du Herren.
Because you are the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Lad os bare give Herren en ordentlig klapsalve.
Let's give the Lord a clap.